Arachne came from the people. Her father was dire and royal. Her mother, too, was commonly born. But Arachne was a prodigy. When she bundled the fleeces, teased out the wool, spun yarn, or conned the images into their places, surely only Minerva could have taught her. Ha! Arachne laughed at the suggestion. Her only talent was her inborn skill. Ha! Let her challenge me, she said. And if she wins, let her do what she wants with me. Ha! Minerva came to Arachne, dressed as an old woman. Her tottering steps, supported by a stick. Old age, she said, teaches that the thread of consequence cannot be broken. Give to mortals the tapestries that make you foremost among mortal weavers, and give to the gods the gratitude for the gift.
If you have daughters, old woman, waste your battle on them. I make up my own mind, and I think as I always do. If the goddess dares practice what she preaches, why doesn't she come to the contest?
Ha! She has come. Arachne flushed deep red in her anger, then pale in comparison, but she stuck to her challenge. Minerva's tapestry portrayed the divine mystery of the gods. Oh. How Jupiter opened Tiresias' inner eyes. He said, the secrets of the universe, they are yours. How the nymphs prayed, let Narcissus suffer as we have suffered. And the gods answered. So briefly a girl is now a boy. And how? Suddenly, Procne's Philomel were flying, and instead of sword, a long, big orb beat. Ha!
Arachne's tapestry showed a difference. She wove. How Callisto fought against Jupiter. Mars rose in fight. And how Juno seized her by the hair and flung her flat on the ground.
How wrath for Dionysus, besieged by some narcissist.
Has also lived and loved
in the body of a man.
There is a fellow called Tiresias.
Who?
Tiresias.
Who strove to see the birds and hear the bees. He came upon two serpents copulating. He took the opportunity to kill both with a single blow. But merely hurt them and found himself transformed into a woman. Now, after the 7 years of woman, strolling to ponder whatever women ponder, he saw in that same place the two serpents knotted as before in copulation. If by your pain you can still change your attacker just as you once changed me, then change me back. And he hit the couple with a handy stick. And there he stood, as male as any man.
In his name, why you slave?
Yes.
He sees the number! The gold, please!
Ladies and gentlemen, Tiresias will now bang that number out on this dog. We'll try again.
Stone was sank into humus, but her
voice wandered off by itself. Unseen on the mountain, unseen in the forest, though all could hear it.
Thank you. When he entered the land of the dead, Narcissus couldn't resist it. He ran straight to the bank of the River Styx and gazed at the smear of the shadow.
Almighty Jupiter! Made the anxious round of heaven's vast bastions.
Let me choose. Which bastion are you from?
Never heard of it.
Oh, pleasure to meet you, sir. And who's this? Fantastic. Got a trick for you. It's a queen. Am I right? Jupiter, king of fucking heaven. Dizzy, there caught his eye. A virgin, nymph of Diana.
Ooh. And love played in his heart.
Restrained her dress,
a pen for wild maid.
She carried a light spear, sometimes a bow. Diana's warrior.
None so high as
she in Diana's favor, yet favorites soon fall. One afternoon,
the sun still rising high,
she found a glade deep in the virgin woods, and lay down among the grass. Jupiter saw her there, weary and unprotected and alone. My wife won't notice a little cheating, he thought, but if she does, how worth the fight? He took at once Diana's hand. Her face,
her dress. Hey, Callisto.
Hey, Goddess. Great Jupiter, and I don't care if you're here.
Jupiter smiled, happy that she preferred him to himself.
How's the hunt?
Kiss of a virgin. She is saying where she hunted. He stops her with enveloping arms, revealing himself and his crime. Oh, she fought. It's true. It's true. As hard as girls can fight. You know, Juno, if you had seen her, your wrath might have been less. She fought. But how could any girl succeed to master Jupiter? Victorious, he retires.
She loathed the forest of age, the woods that knew it as she turned to go, nearly forgotten her and her bow.
And now, Diana, across high the alleys, observes the girl and calls her. At her call, Callisto shrinks, lest it were Jupiter. But seeing the nymphs come with their queen, she fears no trap and joins their call. But oh, it is so difficult to keep the guilt from your face.
Greco-Roman myth. Was she trying to shoot the deer or the hart?
Thereby has a shaved head. Look closely, folks. She has shaved the hair off her head. Now, what does that tell you about Bearmon? Ladies and gentlemen, let's talk to one of her hunting buddies now. Nymph, was Bearmon a fierce hunter?
She was the fiercest hunter I ever knew. The one thing about her is that she always caught her prey.
She always caught her prey. Hop! Ladies and gentlemen, next, let's take a look at the events of that night. What do we know? We know that Bearmon had sexual relations with Jupiter. Who is Jupiter? Jupiter is a family man with a lovely children. He holds an important position in the universe. Now let's all just take a few minutes to think about how this has affected him. How devastating this must be for his family, his followers. Bearmon's reckless behavior is literally tearing apart the fabric of the universe! After Bearmon's tryst with a married man, what did she do next? Ladies and gentlemen, she continued to hunt! That is right! After ravaging a married man, she was ravenous for the flesh of an animal. Just like Beauty and the Beast, but who is the beauty? And who is the beast? Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to take it out to the audience now. Please, has anyone here ever been cheated on? It's okay, you don't have to be shy. Just raise your hands. Go ahead, it's a safe space here. Has anyone ever been cheated on here? Raise your hands. Yes, you sir. You sir. Could you tell us a little bit about how it felt?
Yeah, yeah.
Their virginity. After Bearmon carelessly threw away her maidenhood, was she honest about her fall from grace? Did she tell her dearest friends? No. Bearmon went so far as to hide the baby that was growing inside of her. Day after day, she hunted with those women and lied to their faces. What does that tell you about her character? Is this a woman that can be trusted? No. How many other times has she lied? Hop!
The years rolled on. Arcus is now 16. Mother lost. Her name, her fate, unknown. One day, while hunting in the glades, he chanced to meet her. Seeing him, she stood stock still, seeming to recognize his face. He shrank away from those eyes which seemed to gaze forever into his own, as they froze his heart with a nameless fear. When she moved toward him, he raised his javelin to strike her dead.
Almighty Jupiter, carried away the bodies and the crown. He caught them in a wind whirling through space and set them in the sky as constellations alone.
Filtering out every feel of mere ivory. He flattered her. He brought her love gifts, knickknacks, speckled shells, gem pebbles, little rainbow birds in pretty cages, flowers, pendants, drops of amber. Hung pearls in her ears, coiled ropes of pearl to drape across her ivory breast. Then he stripped it all off her, and his brain swam. Pygmalion prayed, watching the smoke of the incense hump shapelessly upwards. He hardly dared think what he truly wanted as he formed the words.
O Venus, you gods have the power to do whatever you
please. You gods have power to give whatever you please.
O Venus,
send me a wife.
And let her resemble.
He was afraid to ask for his ivory woman's very self.
Carved in ivory.
Let her resemble the woman I have carved in ivory. Venus was listening to a million murmurs over the whole island. Yet she heard every word Pygmalion had not dared pronounce. She came near. She poised over him. And the altar fires drank her ascent like a richer fuel. They flared up three times, tossing horns of flame. His hand sprung off her breast as if stung. He lowered it again, incredulous, at the softness, the warmth beneath his fingers. Warm and soft as warm, soft wax, but alive with the elastic of life.
Thank you. first, they don't understand the growing passion inside of me. Still, in my waking moments, I wouldn't allow amorous thoughts to fade my mind. But when I was peacefully resting, a vision of love would appear. Girlfriend,
ears.
Look at you, nice daddy.
Oh, yeah. Oh, no. Fuck! Can you hear?
The years passed.
First love came unexpected to both hearts and wounded them both equally.
But their expectations were quite different.
I always could look forward to the time of wedding torches and wedding vows, and trust that once she leaves a man, will be perfect.
Ooh!
sin and woe.
Thank you.
by signs asked her to take it to the queen.
Charged ahead, confusing, right and wrong,
her whole soul filled with visions of revenge.
It is how like your father you look.
And planned in silent rage indeed. Tragic.
Thank you. Thank you.